Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 2067, Icon Sets for Text. All right, another great question from the Knoxville, Tennessee seminar. This one was from Kristin. I was in the process of showing how to use icon sets on numbers like this, you know, those cool icons. And Kristin raised her hand and said, well, wait, is there any way to apply icon sets to text? Like, she had some ratings, and I asked her a question. I held my breath when I asked this question. I said, how many different ratings do you have? And the answer that she gave me was the perfect answer of 3. Now, hey, if you found this video on YouTube hoping that you're going to be able to set icon sets up for text and you have more than 3, then I apologize. This video is not going to handle what you're going to want to do. But here's how my super secret crazy way of doing this for 3 ratings. What I'm going to do is I'm going to change those ratings to numbers, -1, 0, and 1, like that. And then over here, the VLOOKUP that Kristin was using to get those ratings in, or maybe it was an if statement, I don't know, whatever it was, I'm going to somehow get the words are replaced with 0, 1, and -1, like that. And we have no one failing right now, so let's throw some fails in there, like that, so we make sure that we have some fails. All right, so now once you have these zeros, ones, and minus ones, I'm going to go into conditional formatting, icon sets, and set it up like that. But you're saying, no, that's not solving our problem, that's not text. Oh, here's the super secret thing I want to do. I'm going to go into the number group, to the dialog launcher, and I'm going to go to custom. And in custom, it's possible to specify 3 different zones: what to do if the number is positive, what to do if the number is negative, and what to do if the number is 0. All right, so if we have a positive number, if we have a 1, that's where I want the word great to appear. In quotes, I'm going to say great, like that, and then a semicolon. So the first zone is positive, the second zone is negative. For negative, I'm going to say fail, in quotes, has to be in quotes, and then another semicolon. This is what to do if there's a 0, and if it's 0, then we'll put in average, like that. All right. Look, I'm cheating. We're getting words to appear and then the icon sets. And we'll change someone here from 79 to 95. They change from average to great. The icon changes from the yellow exclamation point to the green check mark. Woohoo! That's awesome, right? Now, hey, here's the hassle. Sure, there's icon sets that handle 5 or 4. That's not the limiting factor. Like, we could use this one or that one. My problem is the custom number formats can't handle more than 3 conditions. I can't trick Excel into giving me different words beyond those 3. So that's where the whole thing falls apart. But still, hopefully a cool trick if you have 3 different sets of text like that. Icon sets are discussed in my book, Power Excel with Mr. Excel. Click that I in the top right hand corner to check. All right, wrap up of this quick episode. Can you apply conditional formatting icon sets to text? Well, no. But if you have 3 or less than 3 ratings, you can use the trick in this episode. Convert those text ratings to 1, 0, and minus 1. Apply the icon set to those numbers, and then you use a custom number format in this format where we have in quotes what to do if it's positive, what to do if it's negative, what to do if it's 0. Oh, there's a bug there. Hang on. That should be a semicolon. Semicolon between each of those zones, not a comma. There we are. That'll get the words to appear instead of numbers. Well, yeah, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel. Now, we should have a little theme song for It's Outtake Video Time. You know, anytime I say that something can't be done, I learn that, of course, it can be done. You could have 5 different words and 5 different icons. That would work. So, the first thing I did here is I had the numbers 1 through 5. You see up there, you know, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And went in and applied conditional formatting and one of the icon sets that has 5 icons, right? So just choose any of the ones with 5. And then manage the rules, and in that one, change all of these to be numbers, change all of these to be greater than or equal to, and then 5, 4, 3, 2. And then you can open these little drop downs here and choose the 5 icons you want to use. You don't have to use the ones that are built in. Okay, and then over here, I planned out for each number what text I wanted to have appear. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And of course, I'm being very literal here. In real life, you're going to have, you know, awesome, horrible, whatever. All right, and then just straight out custom number format to all cells, handle the three zones. So normally it's positive, negative, and zero, but you can also specify, no, this first zone is for less than two. Less than two in our case is going to be one, semicolon, less than three. Well, we know if it's not, if it didn't get caught by that one, less than three means it's going to be two, and so we're going to say red diamond. And then for everything else, I'm going to say yellow flag, which handles my number three case. It also erroneously marks four and five with yellow flag, but we're going to handle that in the next step. All right, so then conditional formatting, new rule, we're going to format only cells that contain cells that are greater than or equal to four. And then we go into format. Now let me go back to the one I already set up here, conditional formatting, manage rules, this one here, edit the rule. In the format tab, we can change the fill color, we can change the borders, we can change the font, but we can change the number format. And so here, I put in a custom number format. Remember, we're only here if we're at four or five. And so if it's less than five, we say green flag. If it's anything else, which in this case, it's only going to be five, we say gold star. Insane amount of stuff to do, but it's one of those things that as soon as someone says, oh, you can't do that in Excel, well, you know, some smart aleck, in this case, me, has to improve. Well, no, you could do it in Excel.